Hi guys, Mike here, one good short play. An interesting one this. Today we're playing Chakan, the Forever Man for the Sega Mega Drive. Now, gorgeous looking game for a 16-bit platformer. I remember seeing the screenshots of this and being very excited about it. I also remember rumours that this game was originally associated with the band Iron Maiden, which I can understand why those rumours were coming about, so you'll see from this intro. What happens is basically the guy beats death in a fight, but of course the joke is on him. He can't die, and all he wants is to die, but in the meantime his body just ages and decays and rots. And oh look, he looks a bit like Eddie from the Iron Maiden thing. And I remember rumours about that being associated. I'm not sure how founded they were, probably not at all. Anyone that has an info on that, I'd love to hear about it, because I don't know, was there ever a good Iron Maiden game ever made? I don't know. I was a bit of a metal kid when I was a kid, my metal apprenticeship, as some people say. Now this is a great game in some ways, a little bit flawed in others. Weird action fighting mechanic in which you just hold the B button, and it'll do that if you tap it, but if you hold it, that's kind of cool. That should work really well for fight situations. Not sure it does particularly. The thing that really annoyed me about this game is lovely inertia, again the controls, but really slow movements. Actually, it doesn't feel that slow right now, but I remember back on the Mega Drive, the slowness of his movements horizontally became really annoying, especially when you were just trying to do jumps that you could physically make. Like vertically, he can make that jump, but oh, just something about the horizontal movement makes it really awkward to make jumps like that. Maybe it's not possible, that one in particular, but I remember having this sort of problem a lot with the game. So we're going to start with, I'm going to go bottom left because I can't get to top. Actually, I wonder, oh, I can go up here. Top right. I was going to go bottom left, which is probably where I've always started, and the levels are really hard regardless where you go. Let's go in here and see what we get. There we go. Okay, B to hit, C to jump. Don't know what A does yet. She's known as something Rod. Okay, good. Let's find out. You get a little bit of exposition on the enemies that he's... Basically, he's going to kill one by one lots of demons and monsters. That's annoying. Should be able to take them out before they can hurt me. Oh, there's some kind of hole there. I'm guessing that's a way down. So we'll find our way up there and back down, I guess. There's a leap of faith there. I'm not happy about that. Yeah, really not happy about that. But see what I mean about the horizontal movement? It really impedes you. I don't want to go back to the map. I want to go back to the level. Let's give it another go. This, I remember being really annoying and just such a letdown for what would otherwise be an awesome game. Oh, yeah, you guys again. Oh, come on. That doesn't seem right. Okay. Ugh, just fighting with the horizontal controls all the time. I can see down there there's a... Yeah, cool. Cool. At least his vertical controls have got some oomph to them, you know this? I need to... Yeah, double jump. Oh, it's gone all shinobi. Oh, not like that. Oh, I'm not liking that. The glowy floor below me. It's clearly fire. I feel like there is just a pit below me. Oh, look. This is that bit. Ah, work. Oh, come on now. This is that bit, isn't it, that we saw before? We're going to drop down in a minute. Oh, really? That was a bit cheap. There's a fair bit of cheapness in this, isn't there? More than I remember there being, if I'm honest. I want to get across there. See the way out? There's no way I can make it across there. I'm going. Double jump. Come on, Mike. Get it together. Yeah, we found like a secret area now. But where's the reward? There's a lot of wandering. Without reward. They're not like them coming through the floor. Beautiful game. Probably really, really fun when you get to grips with it. Really. Do I want to go down there now, knowing what I know? I don't like it. A lot of leaps of faith. I feel like I want to go back to the left. I feel like I've missed stuff. Oh, get off of me. I mean, that better not be it. What was that, a bit of a restoration for the energy I've just lost getting there? I mean, dude, really? I do love this game. I mean, I did love this game for a bit. So much so that I rebought it, a hard copy, when I started getting the Mega Drive collection back together. But I very quickly got annoyed with it and found myself selling it on. There we go, yeah, we're back there. We know this bit, don't we? It's telling it on again. Oh, stupid Mike, you knew that was there. Oh my goodness. Now that wasn't the game, that was me being stupid. I should know better. You know how I feel about these eternal drops into death. Although technically that wasn't an eternal drop, that was instant death, which is a bit weird for a guy who can't die. I mean, his whole mission in this game is to get to a point where you can die. But really, the game's really helping him out there. Surely, oh, that was cheap. That was cheap. Surely you get infinite lives in that sort of situation. Maybe you do. Actually, I very much doubt you do. It's just a convention that wasn't a convention back then. Infinite lives. This game is very, very difficult though, so you'd think they could have accommodated that and just made it a challenge, you know? Like that I want to be the guy or whatever it's called. I don't think people thought like that though back then. Come on, double jump. There we go. I think there's probably lives and credits. I mean, I can see a load of heads inside there. I guess that's my energy bar. Maybe there is infinite lives in this. I shouldn't have done that. He does seem to survive for quite some time. I mean, over and over again. He doesn't seem to be dying. Hello? Oh, there we go. Maybe I should try a different world. All right, if this one gets the best of me again, which, let's face it, it will. We'll try a different world. I just want to go a little bit further to the right now and see what's over there. Maybe we even get to the boss or something. You know what, I doubt we've even been anywhere near the boss. Oh, that was cheap. All right, forget it. We're going to try a different level. I remember this so well, playing Chakan and just finding myself angry afterwards. There was no chill out factor to this game. You couldn't just chill out and have a game with Chakan because it was really annoying. Can I go off the side now? Cool. You can't die in this bit. Love that animation though. Weird little stunted walk thing he's got going on. Love his little stance, love his little sword movements. Normally, animations that only move one part of the body and not others. Dragonfly King, cool. Don't look good, but in this game, that whole moving the swords around, I think works rather well. Usually that sort of motion wouldn't work, but it works well. It's quite unique. Again, we're fighting with the horizontal controls. Desperately trying not to fall short of the jumps I need to make. And again, these swords are really annoyingly weak against the amount of... Oh no! Oh, of baddies we're up against. There's a lot of falling to your death in this game. I think that's annoying too. The thing is, I really wanted to like this game. I was a kid of the 80s, 90s, kind of action platformers, I loved Strider on the Mega Drive. I loved Altered Beast, as you guys know. I loved, what else did I love? The likes of Wolfchild on the Amiga. Goodness, I loved that game. And its 80s mulletisms. I loved all that. I loved the likes of Aladdin and the Disney platformer. Well-made platformers, I loved. Chakan, I really, no, wanted to love. But I really wanted to love it. I love the graphics. I love the idea. Just something about the design of this game makes me so angry. To the point where, when I rebought it, thinking, surely it's better than I remember it being. And then played it a few times. It occurred to me that I really needed to get rid of it from my collection because it's cheap and oh, so nasty, with so many leaps of faith and so many deathly drops into the infinite void. It makes me angry, this game. It makes me really, really angry. Double jump fail. You do get infinite lives, which for some reason doesn't help. You know what, this game's probably awesome if you've got the tenacity to use those infinite lives and actually get to know the levels. That double jump was not very reliable. I'm just not very practiced at it. But can you see how I've got to the point now where I'm dying instantly over and over again? And I find it happens on every level after a while. I think I've completed one or two levels. And then I just get angry and short-tempered with this game. And it's a shame, because it's beautiful, and it sounds good, and it looks good, and it should be good. There's just something not broken, but oh, that makes me angry about the design of it. Anyway, Chakan, Sega Mega Drive, make of it what you will. Thanks for watching.